Windows 10 loses support this October 2025. But which versions of Windows 10? Stay tuned. All right, 2025, October 14th, Microsoft stops support for Windows 10. But what does that mean? And which versions of Windows 10? There's a lot of confusion out there. We get questioned every day about, does this affect me and my license of Windows 10? And also, what does end of support mean? And so the quick, simple answer, end of support is when there are no more security patches, hot fixes, or tech support for that product. The product itself, if you have a license for Windows 10, is good forever. Your computer will run forever. But come that date in October, there will be no more security patches. So your system becomes, you know, open to being hacked or getting a virus, or you know, just far less secure, if you will. Now, the question we always get is in the IoT channel is, well, what about the IoT version? Is it also losing support then? So there's a lot of confusion around which versions of Windows 10 are losing support this October. Let's talk about that. Let's start with the non-IoT version. So these are the non-IoT. This is your home and pro, enterprise and enterprise LTSC. Those are available through consumer, retail, system builder, open volume, CSP volume, all the various volume channels. So they're not in the IoT, not in the OEM IoT channel. That's why I call them non-IoT. So starting with Pro, Pro and Enterprise, both of those versions are losing their support October 14, 2025. Now, for the first time in history, Microsoft is going to offer an option called ESU, or Extended Security Updates, and it'll be available for 3 years. Now, you don't have to buy all 3 years. You can just buy 1 year at a time, but you can't skip over a year. So if you're going to take yourself all the way through year two, you're going to have to buy year one and then year two. They stack on top of each other. There's no skipping the years. And the way it works, and what we've learned from Microsoft via their website, is that the product is going to cost about $61 for year one, and then it will double each year thereafter. So you're talking about $122 and then $244. So for 3 years, that's quite a bit of money to spend, but that will continue the security updates. And in years past, you had to be an OEM or a direct OEM to get access to extending the security updates, and it was very expensive. So this is kind of the first time that Microsoft is opening the door for consumers or end users or corporations that want to extend their stuff. Now, Windows 10 Enterprise is an upgrade to Pro, and it's typically purchased by corporations or bigger companies that upgrade their Pro systems to Enterprise to get the additional features. But that product will also be losing its support, and if a company isn't ready to go to 11, the extended security updates is an option for them as well. And then the third one there is your Enterprise LTSC, Long-Term Service Channel. In the non-IoT channels, the LTSC version does not get 10 years, or I guess it's very specific to the version, but the 2021 version did not get 10 years. It only got 5 years, and that's why it takes it to 2027. It was launched technically in 2022, the end of 2021, so it goes to 2027. Well, right at the start of 2027, right? So it's basically a 5-year support window that it got. And as far as we know right now, there are no extended security options available for that product because it already had a little bit longer life cycle. Now let's talk about our Windows IoT channel, which is an OEM channel intended for OEMs that build fixed purpose appliances. The first two products we have are what we call the GAC products. Sorry, the first one is a GAC. The second one is an LTSB. The first one, which went end of life back in 2023 and has been gone for a couple years now, it's just going to have end of support the same time as Windows 10 Pro, which is your October 14th, 2025. And as far as we know, there are no security, extended security options. So no options to extend that product. If you're on that product, you need to get to Windows 11 or switch to a long-term service channel, LTSC version. The super old 2015 version, which was called LTSB, long-term service branch, that version is also ending this October. And although we sold a lot of it, most of our OEM customers jumped on the 2016 version that came out 1 year later. So the majority of customers and the majority of the purchases were on the 2016 edition. And that's why there is a strong possibility that a ESU option will be available for the 2016 LTSB version. That version, as you can see by the chart, doesn't end support until October 26. And the reason for that is it was launched in 2016. It got 10 years of support until 2026. And thus, you got one extra year of support. And then it's a possibility that Microsoft might release ESU options for that. It hasn't been confirmed yet. We don't have part numbers. We don't have any confirmation that it's going to happen. But because so many licenses were sold of that version, there's a good chance that it might be available. And then if we look at the other LTSC versions, jumping to the 2019, that product takes you all the way out until 2029, and it's too soon to talk about ESU options for it. You have to get within a year to 2 years, a year and a half, of the support ending before Microsoft starts even thinking about ESU options, so that one's still a ways out. And then lastly, the most current and last version of Windows 10, called LTSC 2021. That takes you all the way out till January 2032 on support. And as you can see from this chart, it is going to be the last supported version of Windows 10. It takes you the longest. So if you're on Pro and you are an OEM that's building appliances, and believe me, Pro is my biggest competitor. Sometimes OEMs that build appliances still use Pro because the machines they buy include Pro. So it's sometimes it's difficult to try to talk them out of Pro and get them onto IoT, LTSC. So if you're one of those, now's your chance for sure. If you don't want to go to Windows 11, you can stick with Windows 10 for many more years by jumping to the IoT version, which has far more other features that make it better than Pro. More secure, more ways to lock it down, more features, single product key, less expensive, longer life cycle, on and on. Windows 10, Windows 10 Pro, Home and Pro itself went end of life 3 years ago in 2022. So that product's been gone. So another note, if you see those products online for sale, odds are high they're pirated because they haven't been manufactured or produced since 2022. So don't think that you can just run out and buy a Windows 10 license and think it's legit because it's available. In many cases, it's not. Definitely want to move to the IoT. Longer life cycle, longer support. It's definitely the way to go. So with that, thank you guys for watching the channel. Drop a comment down there if you have questions. Shoot us an email, windowsiot@arrow.com. Happy to help you guys keep your support going for Windows 10. If you're thinking of moving on Windows 11, check out my other videos, and we'll cover all the options for Windows 11. Thank you guys for watching.